अक्षिणी तस्य निर्भिन्ने ह्यक्षिणी तस्य निर्भिन्ने ह्यक्षिणी तस्य ज्योतिः चक्षुः गुणग्रहः ज्योतिश्चक्षुर्गुणग्रहः ज्योतिश्चक्षुर्गुणग्रहः यदात्मनि निरालोकम् आत्मानं च दिदृक्षतः निर्भिन्ने ह्यक्षिणी तस्य
desired to see himself and all that was created. Then the eyes, the illuminating God, Sun, the power of vision, and the object of sight, all became manifested. Please repeat the translation. Thus, when everything existed in darkness, the Lord desired to see himself and all that was created. Then the eyes, the illuminating God's Sun,
the power of vision,
and the object of sight,
all became manifested.
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The universe is by nature dense darkness, and therefore the total creation is called tamas or darkness. The night is the real feature of the universe. For then, one cannot see anything, including oneself. The Lord, out of His causeless mercy, first desired to see Himself and all the creation as well. And thus, the Sun became manifested, the power of vision for all living entities became possible, and the objects of vision were also manifested. This means that the whole phenomenal world became visible after the creation of the Sun. I'll read a few more verses. Text 22. Bodhyamanasya rishibhir atmanas atmanas tadjigrishataha karnau chanir bhityeta dishahashtotam gunagraha. Translation. By development of the desire of the great sages to know the ears, the power of hearing, the controlling deity of hearing, and the objects of hearing became manifested. The great sages desire to hear about the self. Purport. As stated in the Bhagavad Gita, by advancement of knowledge, one should try to know about the Supreme Lord, the sum and bone of everything. Knowledge does not mean knowledge only of the laws of nature or physical knowledge, which are working by the direction of the Lord. The scientists are eager to hear about the physical laws working in material nature. They are eager to hear through the medium of radio and television about things taking place far away from them on other planets. But they should know that the power of hearing and the instruments for hearing were given to them by the Lord for hearing about the Self or about the Lord. Unfortunately, the power of hearing is misused in hearing the vibrations of mundane affairs. The great sages were interested in hearing about the Lord through Vedic knowledge, nothing more. That is the beginning of oral perception of knowledge. Lesson Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuram Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaha Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So here is further description of the creation, that the Lord is making everything possible for us to actually live in this world. We are dependent on our senses, and the senses also need to have the power to function. Sensual power is different from the senses. And just because somebody has got eyes does not mean he can see. The eyes are required, and we also require the power to see. Just like I've got eyes, but my power to see is not sufficiently strong, so I have to use these glasses. So the Lord is giving the instrument senses, the eyes, the ears, and also He is giving the power to see, the power to hear. Now, the power to hear and the instrument sense, that is the ears, again are not enough. There is also need for the object of the senses, called Vishaya, Indriya Vishaya. Indriya means the sense. Indriya Vishaya means the object. Just like for the ears, there is a necessity of sound. Sound vibration must be there. There are different kinds of sound vibrations. So these sound vibrations can be perceived by the ears through the power of hearing. And above all this, there is a controlling deity. The whole mechanism, the ears, the sound, and the power of hearing, everything is controlled by one deity, controlling deity of hearing. Or the eyes, the power of seeing, and the object that is seen, controlled by the sun, because the sun provides not only the light but also controls the sense of seeing and the objects themselves, which are becoming visible. Not all objects are visible. Just like air is blowing, we cannot see the air. Correct? We cannot see the air. We can feel the sensation of touch. We can feel the air blowing. Or when there is some sound being made, when the air is blowing, then we can hear the wind is blowing, making some sound. But you cannot see the air. So this seeing also is made possible by the sense object, which has got a definite form. Form, sound, all these are created by the Lord. Now try to understand, in the spiritual world there is no creation. There is no form which is created. There is no sound which is created. There is no sound. Here, there is a need. Just like I use my hand, I bang this table, then there is sound generated. If I use one piece of cloth, I do like this, no sound. So there is a generation of sound. All this is done by the Lord. This is creation. Some cases sound is generated, some cases sound is not generated. Some objects have form which is visible, some objects have form which is not visible. Air cannot be seen. So these characteristics are all created at the beginning of creation. And the Lord has also made arrangement that everything is controlled by empowering certain deities. Actually, the purpose of this creation is being described in this 22nd verse, that why all this arrangement? One is that the living entities want to enjoy materially. So there is this arrangement for seeing or hearing or touching or smelling or whatever. But there is a higher purpose. That higher purpose is described in the 22nd verse. By development of the desire of the great sages to know. Everybody has a desire to know. Knowledge. Everyone wants knowledge. But what kind of knowledge? Specifically it is said here, the great sages desire to hear about the self. Now self means Atma. Atma, two kinds of Atma. The Supreme Soul or God, and each one of us the individual souls. So the power of hearing should be utilized, or one's desire to know should be directed towards knowing or hearing about God. That is the real purpose or proper utilization of the power to hear. We can hear about so many different subject matters. And as Prabhupada points out, the scientists, they are very eager to hear about the working of this material nature. Why? Because they want to exploit nature for their enjoyment. This is the reason why they want to know or hear about material nature. But when it comes to God, say, oh no, 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 there is no God. Or they are informed about God from the scriptures, because God they hear is, or they come to know is the controller, supreme controller, then they are not interested. Then they want to be godless. But that is not a very wise or intelligent thing to do, to ignore or neglect or deny knowledge about God. Because only when we hear about God, or only when we know about God, can we understand the ultimate truth or reality by which actually we will be able to make a complete solution to all our problems in material existence. Everybody is interested in knowledge, and even if somebody wants knowledge to solve their problems, what knowledge can solve all their problems? That is described in the scriptures as Atma Vidya. Now this Atma also should be understood to be of two different kinds. Atma is the self. Atma is the ultimate reality, absolute truth. But Atma, there are two kinds of Atma, very distinctly distinguished in all the scriptures. In the Bhagavad Gita, in the 13th chapter, Krishna explains that the object of knowledge, jnana, is knowledge, and jnaya, jnaya means object of knowledge. By acquiring knowledge, what is it that you must really try to know or understand? That object of knowledge, jnaya, is described as Atma. You should try to know about Atma by hearing or by studying or by acquiring knowledge. You should try to know about Atma. Now this Atma has been described in the 13th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita as of two different kinds of Atma. One is the limited, tiny spirit soul, the individual spirit soul, the living entity, Jivatma. And then there is the Paramatma, Upadrishta, Anumanta, Bharta, Bhokta, Maheshwara. Paramatma iti cha api uktaha desmin purusha parama. In this body, there is the individual soul. You are seated in your body, but you are described as Jivatma, Jiva, living being, living being is very, very tiny, is limited. And then there is also, in the same body, there is Paramatma, who is witness, who is sanctioning, Upadrishta, Anumanta, Bharta. Bharta means he is the maintainer. Bhokta means he is the transcendental enjoyer. Dehe is mean Purusha Paraha. He is a transcendental Purusha. He is a transcendental enjoyer in this body. We are also trying to enjoy sitting in this body, but our enjoyment is material. Our enjoyment is material. But Paramatma, seated also in this body, is another Atma who is superior, supreme, Paramatma, Parampurusha, supreme person. So we should try to know or hear about the supreme person. And the scriptures explain that if you try to know about Paramatma, then automatically you will get knowledge about yourself also, Jiva, automatically. In the absence of knowledge of Paramatma, you cannot understand yourself properly. Some people, they just try to understand or know about the individual self. Who am I? So in some places in the scriptures, this is explained. Koham, who am I? So the answer, soham, kaha, aham, becomes in sandhi, koham, who am I? So the answer in the Upanishads, soham, soham means saha, aham, I am that. What is that? That is described as some places the truth, the reality, not the illusion. So this body is a product of illusion, illusory energy. So I am not this body. Then what are you? Then it is described you are the truth, reality, beyond this illusion. So what is the nature of that reality? So to understand the nature of that reality beyond illusion, that which you are, your real identity, your real person, who you are, that can be understood only when you understand the ultimate truth, God, Krishna, the Supreme Personality, Paramatma. So the distinction has to be made between the individual soul, Jivatma, and Paramatma, and that can be understood only when one takes to bhakti. Only when there is bhakti, Paramatma is revealed. Without bhakti, one remains in ignorance about Paramatma. Without bhakti, if a person is materialistic, then the person only comes to know about matter, either gross matter or subtle matter. But if a person becomes a spiritualist, still, if he is a non-devotee, without bhakti, he cannot understand God. He can only understand something about spirit. spirit soul, something about Atma he may understand. But the complete truth is not understood in the absence of bhakti. Because bhakti is the only way. Bhaktyamam abhijanati yavan yat cha asmi tatvataha. If you want to know in truth the actual position or situation of Krishna, of Paramatma, of the Supreme Person, of the ultimate reality, then bhakti is the only way. Several places in the Bhagavad Gita is explained, in all the scriptures it is explained. Bhaktya tu ananyaya shakya aham evam vidho arjuna jnatum drashtum cha tatvena praveshtum cha parantapam. When Krishna showed his original form to Arjuna after showing the universal form, then Krishna tells bhaktya tu ananyaya shakya aham evam vidha arjuna. I can be known in my this form, particular form, as two-handed Krishna, only by bhakti. And what kind of bhakti? Ananya bhakti, pure devotional service. Many places in the Bhagavad Gita, in the scriptures, in the Vedic literature, everywhere in the Upanishads, in the Vedanta Sutra, everywhere it is explained that the ultimate reality can be known only through bhakti. And what does bhakti reveal? Bhakti reveals the two kinds of Atma. The Supreme Atma, superior Atma, the ultimate person, the Supreme Person. And then automatically everything which exists in this world or in the spiritual world or everything that exists at all is always existing in relationship with Him. So everything becomes known. When you understand or come to know about the ultimate reality, absolute truth, then you know everything. In the Upanishads it is said, yasmin vijnate sarvam evam vijnatam bhavati. If you know the Supreme Lord, then you know everything. And Krishna also declares in the 7th chapter, if you come to know about the absolute truth, then you know everything. Nothing remains to be known. Nothing remains to be known if you know about the absolute truth, God. Therefore, here it is declared in this particular 22nd verse that the sages desire to hear about the Self, and this Self is the Supreme Self, God, Krishna. So, through the Vedic knowledge, also the ultimate object of knowledge is the Supreme Lord. Vedaishcha sarvair ahameva vedyam. From all the Vedas, what is to be known, what is to be understood? It is Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. Then everything becomes known. So we should utilize our power of hearing, or we should utilize our desire to know, simply to know about or hear about the Supreme Lord Krishna. And that is why Bhagavatam declares that Bhagavatam is going to give you knowledge about Krishna. That's why Bhagavatam exclusively deals with knowledge about Krishna. And to isolate दशमस्य विशुद्ध्यर्थं नवानां इह लक्षणम् टू आइसोलेट द ट्रांसेंडेंस ऑफ कृष्णा फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट मैटर देयर आर 10 सब्जेक्ट्स बट अदर 9 आर मेंट टू हेल्प अस अंडरस्टैंड द ट्रांसेंडेंस ऑफ कृष्णा हाउ कृष्णा इज बियॉन्ड दिस मटीरियल क्रिएशन Because Krishna appears to be like a person of this world. So very easily people mistake God to be a person of this world and therefore they don't seriously consider the activities or the name or the form or the descriptions of God, Krishna, they don't take it very seriously. Typically, the impersonalists, when there are descriptions in the Itihasas, Puranas, even in the Vedanta Sutra, or in the Upanishads, in the Vedas, in the Mahabharata, in the Ramayana, when there is description of the personality of Godhead, Rama, Krishna, Narasimha, or they take this is all simply some descriptions of